this is not HD Bailey. This is HD Bailey, bringing you another LP in HD. So if you're looking for a 100% walkthrough, then come and let's play Final Fantasy XV for the PC. This is also available for PlayStation and Xbox and all that, but I decided to use the PC version of the game for this one. Let's check the options here real quick. There's a couple settings that I want to change from what I did in the preview episode there. I wanted to turn this setting off because that seems to really help with the performance of the game, at least. And I also wanted to turn off the motion blur as well there. But everything else is the same as before. If you want to look in more detail of the graphical settings that I'm using for this LP. And I also went over like some background plot and some of the gameplay mechanics in the preview episode so that we could just hop right into the game here. So let's get started. Of course, we're going to be going on normal difficulty as usual, but I don't need to go through the tutorial. Again, we can just get it on. Like the reference to the first Final Fantasy, the first of many Final Fantasies. Well, seems pretty straightforward to me. Chapters of the Chosen? No, that's another game of yours. So who do we got here? Ah, there we go. Pretty hot day, huh? Scorching, in fact. So, what are we doing here? Can I just, like, run away if I wanted to? You can move around this whole place, but, no, I guess we can't run away. Okay. They don't let you see what's going on back there. Well, I guess we're supposed to be fighting that guy. So, yeah, let's jump right in. Whoa! Ow.
Hang in there, buddy.
You're on fire today!
We'll keep him busy.
So what now?
Over here.
Oh, okay.
Quickly, before he strikes again!
I can't move as fast as I did before.
Here comes! I got your back!
Here you go.
Yeah, that's one hell of a first boss. What's going on? What was that all about? It's probably not important. I wouldn't worry about it. So where are we? Got some kind of a rippling effect going on there.
The decreed hour is come.
Hey, how's it going?
Set forth with my blessing, Prince Noctis.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
Daddy-o.
Take your leave and go in the grace of the gods.
Right.
How many gods do we have around here anyhow? Well, I suppose in a world where every day is a struggle for survival, you need all the gods you can get. Indeed. Nice throne room you got there, dude.
Well, princes will be princes.
So much for royal protocol.
Not like you had to deliver a formal address.
Your Highness!
What now? What happened to your leg?
What now?
I forgot he said that there.
I fear I have left too much unsaid. You place a great burden on those who would bear with you.
What do you mean?
You're one to talk.
I ask not that you guide my wayward son. Merely that you remain at his side.
Ah,
indeed, Your Grace.
We'll see the prince to Altissia if it's the last thing we see.
Yeah, what he said. Hate to break this up, but Kor's got the motor running. Drados, he's in your hands.
And another thing. Do mind your manners around your charming bride-to-be.
Okay, sure.
Majesty as well. Try to mind yours around our esteemed guests from Niflheim.
You have no cause for concern.
Nor do you.
Take heed. Once you set forth, you cannot turn back.
You think I would?
I cut the brakes on the car.
I need only know that you are ready to leave home behind.
Don't know about you, but I'm ready as I'll ever be.
Take care on the long road.
How long could it possibly be?
Wheresoever you should go, the line of Lucis goes with you.
What does it even mean?
Walk tall, my son.
I'm not as tall as Gladio, but alright. Hey, an achievement unlocked! You could play the game without falling off your chair! Well then. Kind of a strange achievement, but I'll take what I can get. But alright, so let's see, where are we going? Ah, okay. So I guess we're heading off to a wedding. No rescuing princesses or anything like that? Apparently not. God help you if you don't have a solid-state drive to play this game. Holy cow, the load times are really long in the PS4 version. From what minimal experience I've had. For some reason, the camera panning around here seems to really put a load on my PC or my VRAM. But adjusting the settings really helped it out. Just some minor tweaks.
I think we can forget about hitching our way there. Thought people were friendly outside the city.
You can only coast so far on the kindness of strangers.
That's...
You're just gonna have to push her all the way.
I've already pushed myself to the brink of death.
Get up.
Maybe laying down on hot concrete wouldn't be such a good idea.
Move itself.
Jeez.
But yeah, I've got the subtitles on.
Supposed to move us.
Wouldn't that be nice?
Can it? Ready, steady.
Push. That way you can tell what's going on when I'm talking over the cutscenes. Not that there's very many cutscenes in the game, but it's there. This is a much more open game than most Final Fantasy games.
Unbelievable.
Not exactly a fairy tale beginning, huh, Prince Noctis?
We let ourselves get carried away.
What do you mean?
These things happen.
Weren't you driving?
Let's just hope this isn't some omen.
Gladio?
No, of course not.
What?
Push this thing by yourself.
All by myself?
You won't even notice if we just let go.
Prompto, don't even think of that.
Now you're just talking crazy.
For pushing.
Ignis, come on, time to switch.
Nah, we just switched back there.
You moved the car 10 feet.
His turn.
My hands are killing me.
You rather I kill you with mine?
Easy there, tough guy.
Would you rather I set you on fire?
Is it just me? Or was it supposed to be way closer?
I assure you, the map is correct.
The map said Hammerhead was right there.
What's a map?
Next door.
Looks that way. On a map of the world.
How big could the world possibly be? But yeah, this is a very, very, very long game. So
the world's a big old place.
The episodes are gonna be pretty long.
Tell that to my legs.
Compared to my usual stuff.
Hard as I can.
Yeah, I'll never forget the title screen display, or well, the name of the game in like Final Fantasy IX, there with all the airships and everything going on. I'm just always reminded of that one in particular. So where are we? A hammer store? Well, I guess I gotta sell hammers somewhere. Well, at least we made it? Wherever we're going?
Hey there, y'all kept a girl waiting.
Hey, how's it going?
Now, which one's the prince? Hello, your highness. Congrats on your wedding.
Thanks.
Not hitch just yet.
Lady Lunafreya's groom-to-be, here in Hammerhead.
Couldn't hitch a ride.
You best save your apologies for Pawpaw.
What do you mean?
Well, that makes you...
Cindy. Sid's grease monkey granddaughter.
Roll her in while I'm still young.
Can't you do that?
Didn't your daddy tell you? She's a custom classic, not some beat-up old clunker.
Well, evidently not.
Prince Noctis.
Broke down already.
Yeah.
Prince. Like they took your old man and kicked the dignity out of him.
What?
What do you mean?
You got a long way to go, son. And that slack jaw's getting you nowhere fast.
Oh. Okay. Can you fix it or not?
She's gonna take a while. Y'all get her in and run along.
Oh, okay.
Y'all heard him. Let's get moving. Right this way.
So you got like a towing cable or something?
Now we play the waiting game.
Never liked that game.
Never any good at it either.
How many things could there possibly be for us to do around here? Well, let's see what we got. Do we talk to her first?
Y'all ain't never been out this way before, have you? Go on, have a look around. This'll make sure y'all don't get lost.
Oh. I thought we had a map. I guess not. Oh. Okay, sure, why not?
Well, might as well make good use of the extra time.
Well, what are we gonna do? Where are you going?
Oh. They got Ebony out here. Oh, Ignis is gonna flip.
Wait, what's a gill?
What's Ebony? Oh, hey, there's a lady there. Remember her for later, viewers. But, okay, yeah, Ebony is, I think it's a brand of coffee. Or maybe an energy drink? I think it's coffee.
I got a feeling our money's no good here, Noct.
Well, what do you mean?
Ignis came prepared, though. Let's ask him.
Enough for room and board.
What, they don't accept gold? What gives? Oh, right. Well, gas isn't going to do us very much good now.
A moment, Noct. We've expended the last of our funds on the repairs. I suggest we confer with Cindy.
Oh. Down and flat broke.
Adding insult to injury.
Old man's in for both after charging us that much.
Well, okay, we got our first main storyline quest here. So, yeah, we gotta talk to Cindy, I suppose. And we got the whole map here, and it is really, really big.
Yeah, let's pay him a visit.
But all right. So, yeah, we gotta talk to Cindy to move along here.
She ain't gonna be ready for a while. Y'all need something?
Especially when you're not working on the repairs. I don't know that it matters which option you choose with Cindy here, though sometimes different options give you different rewards.
Hate to ask, but could we borrow some cash?
Oh, now I get it. This must be what Papa meant when he said he was gonna teach them boys a lesson.
With the bill?
He told me he ought to have y'all take care of some ornery varmints that have been causing a ruckus around here.
Oh, okay.
I'd be happy to pay y'all for your services if you're up to the challenge. How about it?
How hard could they possibly be?
All according to Sid's plan. I say we play along and teach him not to underestimate us.
Okay. Well, yeah, for going through that conversation, you get some ability points there. But sometimes they'll give you different options, like sometimes it'll give you experience for one party member, or experience for multi-party members, or AP. And AP is generally the way you want to go, especially in the very early game here. So, yeah, instead of like a sphere grid, or license board, or crystarium, we get the Astral Sphere, and you spend your ability points that way. So I'll go over this in a little bit, but not right now.
But don't go running around after dark. The demons are liable to rip y'all to shreds.
And we get equipment there.
A place to stay. Just between us, though. Don't tell Papa.
Oh, okay. Well, all right, let's see what we got here. Let's go into the menu. And then let's equip that new, what was that? The Bangle that we got there. That one, let's see, increases your maximum HP, and Prompto's got the least of it. So I'm going to give that to him to start here. And then down here, we have attire. And those usually have some sort of passive effect on your, well, yeah, on your party members. Like casual outfits can resist some debuffs there and things like that. For the most part, I like using Crown's Guard fatigues because they boost your strength by, I think it's 20%? Let me see what that was. Yeah, about there. But, or yeah, exactly there. So, that's pretty nice. So, yeah, for, well, Noctis, we got the Prince's Fatigues, no jacket. So just go with Prince's Fatigues, no jacket, or Crown's Guard Fatigues, no jackets there. And we don't have, what is it, accessories for everyone there. But let's see what else we got here. Let's see, in our inventory, you might have noticed when I was going through the equipment, we've got some other things along with us as well that were given to us at the very start of the game. These are items, I think they came from like DLC or like limited time events or things like that. Like here we got some accessories or whatnot. As far as this LP goes, I'm not going to be using any items that I did not earn, which would include these ones. So we're not going to be using those. We're going to be starting from scratch here. But if you want to use all that extra stuff, hey, go nuts. But me personally, nah, we'll just leave that alone. Same thing for weapons. They gave us some weapons here. Like with the limited time events, it's like, oh, well, you can't access these items anymore. So we'll just give them to you right at the start of the game there or something. But yeah, I'm not going to be taking advantage of any of that. Just make sure you've got all your party members on the Prince's, or on the Fatigues, no jacket there. Oh, I almost forgot about you. There we go. So yeah, we're going to go with that. Now, as far as weapons go, Noctis can equip any weapon type in the game, but I'm going to usually keep him on like swords or two-handed swords, or well, great swords. And pole arms here for now, but I might change that up later on. Gladio can use great swords and shields. Let's see, Ignis has daggers and pole arms, and Prompto has a handgun, or well, firearms and machine type weapons. So they're limited on their weapon types, but not the, or what is it, not the accessories or anything like that. But I just don't have enough accessories for everyone there. So, all right, let's take a look around here. We got, well, actually, before going shopping, I want to grab a bunch of items around the place. So, let's see, a metal scrap. I want to hold on to that for later because we need it for a side quest later on. And let's see, here we get our first, what is it, an almanac or whatever it's called here. They give you a little background on various locations you visit throughout the game. So I'm going to be collecting all of these entries here in the data log menu. They don't just hand them to you on a silver platter this time around. You got to actually go out and look for them the old-fashioned way. And they have some interesting tidbits there. I'll also be collecting every bestiary entry, every dish or food item in the game, and every fish that you can collect in the game. Got another metal scrap, though I only need the one there. Let's see, in the archives, that's where they have all of these, what is it, like the data log entries there. And yeah, bestiary entries, dish or various recipes you get in the game. We start with 13 of them in the PC version of the game, but I think most of them were either like DLC or from limited time events. So again, I'm not going to be taking advantage of those, but even if I did want to, I probably wouldn't anyway, because I got some other stuff that I wanted to do. And we'll be collecting fish and all that stuff as we go through the game, just not right at the very start here. Okay, let's see. So over here.
Chop, chop, Prompto.
There in a jiffy.
Let's see. We got treasure over here. Rusted bit. We want to save that for later. That is useful for a side quest. And here we get a debased coin. Basically, any items that have the word debased in it, hold on to them for later. They are really, really good. Okay, so let's see. We got a few items over here. Let's see. Extra metal scraps we can sell. That's fine. I'm not going to go too far away from Hammerhead at the start here. But I want to collect every item that I can. Okay, so we got those going there. I think we got three items left to find around here. Okay, now this one can be a little tricky to reach. I gotta land on that platform there. Be a little careful there. But it's going to take me several tries to actually land properly on this thing. If this starts taking me way too long...
Sometimes I wonder if we'll ever sit inside that beautiful car again.
Sitting or what is it? The day was pretty nice.
That room was even better.
But, let's see, I can get up here. Okay, there we go. Okay, got it. There we go. If it was going to take me too long, I would have edited it out. But, there we go. So, yeah, usually platforming is not nearly that difficult in this game.
Sounds reasonable enough.
I mean, what, you think they're going to make a whole dungeon out of jumps like that?
You're joining us.
Okay, so, yeah, we got those two Oracle Ascension coins, and those are basically like mini-medals or small medals from the Dragon Quest series. You can exchange them for really good items later on. Okay, so, yeah, let's check out the diner they got here. Hey, how's it going?
Welcome. What can I do you for?
So let's see. So whoever's at these various diners throughout the game, they're the tipsters that they were talking about before. And if you talk to them, you can get information on the areas around here. Parking spots are like warp points throughout the game. And let's see, those havens I'll go over in a little bit there. And yeah, we've got like treasure spots around here, or ingredients that you can find around in food spots. And those regenerate over time. So once you grab them, then you can come back later and get even more. Okay, let's see. So here we've got hunts. Basically similar to Final Fantasy XII. Where they have a boss or groups of enemies to kill. And you can get rewards.
Take your pick.
So let's see what we got here. We got, well, three hunts here, and we can take on all of them at once.
You boys are a brave bunch.
You can take on up to, I think they said, 10 hunts at a time. So we might as well get them all while we're here. The bottom one we can't get yet, though.
Much obliged.
So let's see, that one I think requires a higher hunter rank or something. Yeah, so you see in the upper right, we're at hunter rank 1. So we gotta complete some hunts in order to get access to other hunts around here. And let's see, while we're here, we can also eat food. Just like, well, I would imagine any number of MMOs. You eat food, and it gives you a stat boost for some amount of time. So, I want to grab this one.
You got it.
Bon appetit.
So, yeah, we get a little boost of attack power and HP. I don't really care about the stat boosts there, because...
I dare say I could make this at camp.
Yeah, we can learn a new recipe from that. So sometimes eating various food at diners will teach you those new recipes. Not all of them, though. Like, What's the other one there? Yeah, that one does not teach us a new recipe, so I don't really care about that one. I just wanted to get the one here, get a little stat boost, and learn a new recipe, or dish, as they call it in the menu there.
Y'all be sure not to overeat.
Okay, I think that's everything I want to do there. So let's head over to the item shop. And I'm gonna, well, sell some things and then buy some other things. So let's see what we got around here. So first, I want to sell some items to get some more money. A bunch of the stuff that we've gotten up to this point. Let's see, we can afford to sell a couple of the metal scraps there.
Much appreciated.
But hold on to one of those. The rusted bits, definitely the debased coins. And let's have the broken harmonica that we found there as well. For the most part, treasures are going to be the bulk of our money that we get throughout the game. Or our source of money there. But there's some of them I'd like to hold on to for other reasons, like side quests, things like that. Let's see. Yeah, let's get things a little organized here. Okay, I would like to buy some stuff then. Let's see. I want to get some repair kits. Yeah, as you can see, they don't work for the regalia, but they can use or be used for minor repairs to cars in side quests coming up later on. So we'll need three of them for chapter one here.
Much appreciated.
And I'd also like to buy some ingredients here. So let's see what we got. I want to get two chocobeans for the burly bean bowl recipe that we've got. And two sweet peppers. But they don't sell the Luncheon tomatoes here. So we're going to have to find some of those at like one of those food spots coming up. Let's see. I think that's everything. Oh, I want to get one more thing. The Luncheon meat there. And for doing that...
Please come again.
That's it.
What's what?
I've come up with a new recipe.
Can't wait to try it.
Yeah, we learn a new dish there. And I hope you like hearing it say that over and over and over again, because you're going to be hearing it a lot. But yeah, so sometimes if you acquire or buy an ingredient, you'll learn a new recipe that way too. There's a lot of different ways that you can learn various recipes throughout the game.
Take a look at our wares.
And I will be doing all of them. Okay, let's see. I would like to buy a broadsword that's going to be quite a bit stronger than what we've got right now.
Pleasure doing business.
And I'd like to get two war swords. One for Noctis and Gladio there. And let's see. I'm not going to buy the Avenger daggers because we can find them in the relatively near future. So... yeah, I won't waste my money, and as you can see, we're on a pretty tight budget as it is. I also want to get the Cocytus, or Cocytus, or however you pronounce it, I don't know. I do want to buy that one, though. Just one. I don't want to buy one for Prompto, because some enemies are strong against ice.
See you later.
And I don't want to be constantly switching up my weapons there for everyone, really. So, let's see what we got here. Okay, so... we got the new broadsword. You want to hold on to the engine blade for later. See how it has that plus symbol in the icon there? That means that it can be upgraded later on with various parts that you can find. So yeah, it'll get much more powerful eventually. And yeah, we can assign various weapons to the D-pad on the controller there. So we can just switch between them from one enemy to the next, or however you want to do that. So let's give him the war sword there. And what else? I want to give the Cocytus to Noctis there. I generally don't like using firearms with Noctis because you can't initiate link strikes with them. But in this case, it's going to be very useful for us for a specific reason that you'll see coming up here. Okay, so let's see. We got all those. Oh, I guess we got an achievement for, well, whatever we did here for equipping multiple weapons or something. Something like that. Okay, so we got that. I think that's all the treasures around here. So yeah, let's make a little save there and then we'll start heading out.
I'm sure the old man is happy to have
one. So we could go, yeah, down to the southwest there to advance the plot, but I want to do some exploration around here. So yeah, let's go take care of that first. This game is very, very open world compared to every Final Fantasy game, really. And I'm going to be spending a lot of time doing the optional content of the game. So I'm going to go to the east.
Gladio, come on.
Gotcha.
Because, well, we can find some good stuff over there. There's a lot of treasures hidden all over the world. I'm aware of about, like, 1,000 of them on the...
Real nice here.
Indeed. Or what is it? On the overworld here. Now, if you want to dash around, just push the L3 button, at least on a PlayStation controller, and you can dash. You see, we got a stamina bar there that depletes as we run for longer periods of time. So let's see, what do we got here? Nothing extraordinary. That treasure point, I think, contains like a random item or something. Sometimes they can contain, what are they? Debased coins. So if you get them, hold on to them. But alright, here we got our first enemy in the game, Mesmineers. Let me check them out here. Now, whenever you see the buttons change on the bottom there, that means I'm switching between my notes that I have outside of the game there. But, okay, Mesmineers are weak to great swords, daggers, and fire. I don't have any fire, but I do have a great sword, so let's put that to use. Now, you notice with these guys, you see I can target both their body or the horn on their head. So enemies have different appendages on them. And if you deal enough damage to an appendage, you can break it off. So let's see, we did a warp strike to start the battle there. And let's see, so yeah, you could, if you hold down the R1 button, you'll scan the enemy to see all of their weaknesses, but I've already got that. Hey, I already broke off the horn there. So you see, we got an item drop from them there. Okay, now you see how I got an AP up top there? That's because I killed the enemy with a warp strike. So that's one way you can get AP from enemies. Is either like with a warp strike or like a link strike. Let's see if I can break off another one of those horns. Okay, you see I'm in stasis there? That means that I'm out of MP. I can't do any more warp strikes. But there's a warp point right up there, and we can get our MP refilled like that. So that's pretty nice. And if you warp strike from a longer distance, you will deal a lot more damage with your warp strikes. Hey, all right, link strike. A blindside link strike. So you see there, I got an AP as well. I think I want to get my MP restored. Warp back here. Warp to the next target. Okay, I want to kill the guy with a warp strike there. Oop, I was a bit too slow on that one, but that's okay. Let's put one of our techniques to use. You see on the left there, we got those green bars. Each one of those bars, well, is a tech bar, and you can use a technique to attack an enemy with one of your allies there. So, yeah, let's give that a try. Can I break the horn? Hey, all right. Finish the guy off with a link strike, and we get some more AP. Hooray! So let's see, I think I got 3 AP out of that, but I also got 10 AP. I kind of glossed over it there. Whoops. that was a strategy prompt. I think it said land 5 attacks on an enemy. So when you go into battles like this, sometimes you'll randomly get a strategy prompt like that. And if you fulfill the condition, you can get a lot of AP out of that. Although at the start of the game, the first few of these ones are predetermined. So that's one of the reasons why I came over here as well. But alright, I'm going to be... Let me see here, as far as AP spending goes. What do I got? Let's go get an ability here. So we got all these different sections of the astral sphere here with a whole bunch of different abilities. It's not like Final Fantasy X or 13 where it's like, hey, you get plus 2 strength or plus 4 strength or things like that. Now, they mix it up quite a bit more in Final Fantasy 15. And the first ability I want to get is in the exploration section of the astral sphere. Happy camping. Whenever you camp out at one of those havens that the tipster pointed out there, you get an AP out of it. And if you get this ability, we can get 2 AP now. Hooray! And eventually I want to get the next one down the line to get 3 AP per camping trip there. But we don't have the AP for that. I just wanted to start out here with this one. And now let's continue eastward, because that's where one of the food spots for Luncheon tomatoes are. And I want to get that as soon as I can here, as well as find some new enemies eventually. I don't think there's very many new enemies around here. Well, I mean, at the start there is, but, you might have noticed. Well, I'll tell you later, but I did a little trick there with my stamina to get it fully restored while I was running there. Okay, here we go. There they are. Okay, we got a new enemy, Reaper Tails. I could probably kill them if I did a warp strike. But, let me see here. Okay. I guess not. Okay, I was too close when I did that. There we go. Okay, there's the strategy prompt. So I need to defend against 3 attacks. So you see how I held down the square button and then pressed circle to counterattack? So that's one defending there. And I'm trying to bait these guys into attacking me. And there we go. So that was a phase attack, I phased through the attack rather than parrying that one. But, we're good to go here. Let's kill the rest of these guys now that we got that strategy prompt taken care of.
Sorry.
And, okay, how are we looking here? And just the one left, I guess. Yeah, they killed the other one there. Oh, well. But, let me see if I can bait them into attacking me again. Nope. I had the warp strike kill that one, or I wouldn't have gotten AP.
This sounds like you're having fun.
Really, game? That's how you're gonna insert the Final Fantasy victory theme into the game? Okay. Well, at least he's nice and cheery, I suppose. Okay, so over here, we got a haven, but... Let's see. Well, not but usually next to havens, we got these, what are they called? Energy deposits. Yeah, there it is. Okay. Okay, so, yeah, these kind of work a little bit like draw points in, like, Final Fantasy VIII, let's say, except there's only 3 different kinds of them. There's fire, ice, and lightning, and those could be used to gather elemental energy to craft spells. I'm not going to be doing that right now, but I do want to get as much elemental energy out of these things as I can. So let's grab a little bit of each of those. You can only get so much at a time, but they'll regenerate eventually. So let's get some more going on here. And, okay, I think there is a treasure down here before the food spot I'm looking for. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Whoa, got that just in time. And here we got another new enemy, Saber Tusks. They are weak to firearms. And what else? So the ice and daggers. But I'm going to be using the Cocytus here to hopefully one-shot them. So let's see what we can do. So let's see. I've got the Cocytus selected here. Exploit two weaknesses. And, oh, I just barely missed killing him. I can do another warp strike, though. Oh, okay. So there's another strategy prompt we got here. Get my MP restored. Phew, barely got that kill there before someone else finished them off. Ha-ha! Yeah, you see how I did that warp there? What is that? Just as the battle was ending to get my MP refilled there. But alright, so far, so good. Let's see what we got here. So here's our first food spot of the game where we can find some tomatoes. So now I have all the ingredients that I need for the recipe there. Let's see, how are we doing on AP? Okay, yeah, we're doing really good. Let's see, I wanted to have at least 24 AP left over by the time I got to the campsite. Actually, I probably could have gone with a little less. Okay, so let me show you something with running around. You see, my stamina is almost running out. When it gets, like, down to the very end of it, press the sprint button again, and you kind of get a second wind with your stamina there to instantly refill it like that. So if you're running across a really, really long distance, you can, well, yeah, keep going for a much longer period of time. So that's pretty nice. But, yeah, let's, camp out here. Oh, okay. So, yeah, whenever you kill enemies, you get experience just like any other Final Fantasy game, but it doesn't, like, count towards your levels until you get it tallied at some sort of a rest point like this. So you can rest up at a campsite, or you might have noticed a trailer back at Hammerhead, or there's a hotel. And different areas have different multipliers on however much experience you've accumulated up to that point. Havens have nothing, but you get AP out of it. So that's why I like to use Havens whenever I can, especially early in the game. So yeah, let's camp out here, and we can also take the time to get a food buff.
Let's call it a day.
All right, I'm gonna pitch the tent.
Now, that AP you get out of resting up at a haven, you only get that if that wasn't the last haven that you rested up at. But we haven't rested up anywhere yet, so yeah, we can just get the AP here. I'm not going to sit through the cutscene every single time I rest up at a campsite, but might as well let it play out. Where were you guys carrying all this stuff? Product placement. Oh! Yeah, there's a bit of product placement throughout the game. Oh yeah, there's that ebony drink that Ignis apparently seems to like. But, yeah, I think it's just like some brand of coffee they made for the game. Not that it's like a plot point or anything. But, all right, so we got the ingredients. And I want to get the, or eat this recipe again. You see in the lower right there where it has like a little sort of a 8-bit or whatever character picture there, whatever we got. That indicates that that is one of Prompto's favorite foods. Different foods can be different characters' favorites. Like this one is one of Noctis' favorite foods. Whenever you get eat someone's favorite foods, for the other three characters, you get a crit on whenever they use their techniques. And if, Noctis eats a favorite food, then it fills up the tech bar quite a bit faster there. I think there's a little more to it than that, but that's essentially the gist of it there. I want to eat this one, being a favorite food of Prompto there, and it also boosts our attack power even more than the original recipe did, I think. And there is an ability later on that also generates AP whenever you eat anyone's favorite food. So here, we get our experience tallied. And we're a little short there. But whenever a character gains a level, you will get 3 AP. So if everyone gained a level here, we would have gotten, 12 additional AP there. Hey, alright. So yeah, whenever you cook at a dish at a campsite, you'll get some skill points towards Ignis's cooking skill. Everyone has a different skill type there. I don't worry about Prompto's. I don't really know what that does. It's not particularly important. But Gladio's, as you're walking around and fighting battles and stuff, that will increase over time. And Gladio can find various items at the end of a battle, potentially. But you don't really need to worry about that one. And Noctis, does fishing. And I'll go over that when we get to that point in the game there. Yeah, whenever you rest up somewhere, we got some pictures here. And you can... What's with that look? Don't answer that, viewers.
Well taken.
So, yeah, sometimes you get a little comment on the pictures you take.
Great timing.
Ooh, that's a nice picture. Just breaking off that horn there. Ooh, that's a really nice one, too. What else do we got? Yeah, that one's okay. Which one of these? I could hold on to as many photos as I want. Yeah, let's go with that one. I like that one a little better there. So you press the square button, you can save a photo there, too. There's no, like, tangible value to that or anything. I just like saving photos throughout the game. You can hold up to, I think, 200. We'll never get that high. There's a cutscene later on that involves various photos you've held on to, but there's no tangible value to it.
Hey, Nox. I've got this thing. Be a pal and come with me tomorrow morning. Pretty please?
Oh, sure. Why not?
All right. No need to beg. Woo! Yes! I owe you one. For now, let's hit the hay.
Sounds like a plan. So yeah, sometimes at specific havens, you can get a side quest from them, or they're called tours. And yeah, we got some objective to take care of, and we can get a reward out of it.
So, what is this thing you've got anyway? Well, it's not a thing. It's a picture.
Uh-huh. Oh, okay.
In honor of the grease monkey goddess.
Uh-huh. What?
Who? Cindy! I want to express my love on film. Dude. No. Not like a stalker
that,
or something.
Just
an innocent display of affection.
That's creepy.
So, first we find a spot overlooking Hammerhead. Then we bow our heads in deference to the garage of our goddess.
You want to go all the way to the garage? Why don't you just ask her for a picture?
Yeah.
No way. That would be creepy.
Can't believe you woke me up early for this.
So you, we are on hallowed ground, Noctis. And if you don't start showing some proper respect, you're gonna have a bad time.
Yeah. I want that.
Okay. You might have noticed I ran out of stamina there because I was distracted there. So you can't run when that happens.
All right, photo boy. Make it snappy.
Nice vantage point.
First,
to pay my respects. Oh, great garage, home to our goddess of the gears. Thank you.
Is that the prince I see?
Cindy?
How's it going?
You're not supposed to.
Just on one of my early morning hikes. Girls gotta stay fit, you know. Ain't it beautiful up here? One of my favorite spots.
Aww.
What are y'all doing here?
Us all? Oh, yeah. Well, you see.
It's like you could use a hand.
I like how Noctis is just kind of smiling there. But, yeah, let's, answer this way. It doesn't matter.
On a hike, just like you.
Well, I'll be. Couple of early birds, ain't ya?
But, yeah, we'll go with that.
Oh, you know, I'm an avid photog. When I get the chance, I'm off hiking and taking pictures.
Well,
Prompto's getting the hang of it.
Fancy that. What are you snapping today, Mr. Cameraman?
So, let's see, yeah, let's go with this one.
Wanna catch old Papa taking a nap? LOL.
Papa? That sounds funnier than a Moogle in a chocobo race. Let me see.
Bet she'd look even better with the two of you in the shop. What do you say?
What are you doing?
That's a pretty fine idea.
Okay. And let me express my love on film. Now I can't see anything. Well, at least we got a decent picture out of that. Yeah, let's hold on to that one.
To think the goddess graced us with her presence.
And what an honor it was.
Yeah, you've got it bad there, Prompto.
All right, mission accomplished.
Thanks to who?
My hero, Noct.
Now, the cutscene itself doesn't have any tangible value. If you chose the other options, it changes the dialogue, but that's it. There's nothing extraordinary that you get out. You always get the 20 AP per tour quest that you do, and, well, that's why I wanted to do the quest there. But alright, okay, so now we're back in action here. So you see Prompto there above the experience there? He's got a little icon that indicates he's got his favorite food buff. So his techniques will automatically crit. And crits don't only apply to like damaging techs, like his piercer technique. They apply to other techniques as well, like Snapshot. And yeah, it uses one tech bar and it takes a photo in battle. And it is one of my favorite abilities in the game. It's pretty abusive. What do you mean you don't believe me? Well, the reason it's abusive is because of the second ability here, Aperture. So whenever you use Snapshot, you have a chance of getting AP. What they don't tell you is that chance is directly related to the crit rate of the ability. So, since I've got the food buff on Prompto, his techniques are going to crit every single time. So every time I use Snapshot, I will get an AP out of that. So whenever I'm fighting random battles where the enemies are relatively easy and it's not going to take very long, I don't need to use like damage techs on them, I could use my excess tech bars on Snapshot to get some AP. And that's one of my more abusive things that I do early in the game with that. Oh, there's also another ability I want to get in the teamwork menu here. First Shot. So it has First Shot is a passive ability that has a random chance of triggering when you initiate combat with enemies. And if it does happen, you get a tech bar. If you don't, then, well, you don't get anything out of it, but it's only 6 AP. And, well, since it generates tech bars, I can convert the tech bars into AP, so that's pretty nice. But alright, so we got all that stuff going on. Let's go put our new technique to use there. Let's see, let's head on up here. I think there's a treasure that I can get around here. I think it's right over here or so. So whenever you're in the in-game map here, press the square button, boom, you can set an icon there that I can see while I'm exploring around here. Let's see, I think there's gonna be some more saber tusks around the corner here. Let's see what we got before I get to the treasure. Yep, there they are. Okay, so yeah, there's a lot of them around here.
The hunt is on.
Okay, used up all of my MP there, so let's find a warp point.
Where'd you learn that one, Noct?
Get my MP restored. And keep on doing warp strikes on these guys, since I can usually one-shot them or two-shot them. Get my MP restored. Let me see. Get down here. Use Snapshot. You see how the bar is yellow up there? That indicates that your technique crits. And I got an AP out of that. Although, in this case, I wasn't able to finish off the enemy in time, so I lost an AP there. But, yeah, you get the idea. So, every time Snapshot crits, you get an AP out of it. So, I generally use food from Havens, or meals, or dishes, whatever you want to call them. I use those whenever... I try to use Prompto's favorite foods, so that way I can always get extra AP out of that. I don't always use Prompto's favorite foods, but I usually do, especially early in the game. You might have noticed from that treasure spot there, we got a debased coin out of it. And that's another random treasure spot there too. So I try to find as many of these rare treasures as, or random treasures as I can, so I can have as many opportunities as possible to get more debased coins there, especially in the early game. See, we got a treasure over there. Let's see, we got one of our hunts that's over to the east there. But that one is much higher level than we are. So I'm going to swing back around here later. I don't want to go any further to the east. At least not right now. Okay, let's get our second wind. There we go. Keep on dashing there. Now let's see. This one is a treasure spot. There we go. Got that. And let's see. Oh, we got two guys over there. Okay, we got another new enemy over there. Okay, so I want to get my javelin ready to go against dual horns. They're level 12, but they're, at least in my opinion, I think they're pretty easy to kill. But they can be a little tough, so if you want to pass on them, you can. You can wait until later until you're more highly leveled. Now, these guys also have an appendage that's a horn, and I would like to try and break it. So keep on targeting the horn, because as you damage it, you'll be able to... what is it? Well, eventually you might be able to break it off. So I want to see... Oh! There we go. Get another parry going there. Whoop! There we go. I want to be careful. Whoop! Yeah, I didn't... what is that? I didn't dodge in time there. But these guys will take a little while for us to kill. Whoa. Let's see.
Get yourself.
So whenever I get a tech bar, I'm going to have Prompto use Snapshot for now. But these guys are pretty close to each other. I want to kind of spread them out a little bit if I can. Aw, man. Yeah, a lot of times when I use a technique,
Prompto,
I'll get like a parry opportunity. But let's see. Okay, I want to keep on trying to break that horn if I can. It does take a little longer to do that than if I like tried to blindside them and deal more damage. But their horns can sell for pretty good money. Okay, we can attack the other one a little bit too. Okay, let's get another snapshot here. So yeah, techniques level up, and that increases their crit rate. Ah, I missed the parry there. I wasn't quite prepared for that. There we go! Broke off the horn. Okay, now we can finish off the guy. Get a good blindside link. Link strikes and blindsides are a very potent source of damage. So you want to try and get them as often as you can. But, okay, let's finish this guy off there. There we go. Got that. And we won a dual horn stake from them. You might have noticed that in the lower left corner there. And, well, you'll see something will happen once we're done fighting these guys. If you want to run from a battle, you can leave the red circle area there. But I don't want to run from battles. I almost never do that. Let me see what I can do there. Okay, let's get that one. Now, you see that break that happened there? That wasn't breaking the horn. That was breaking the body there after dealing some amount of damage. And you see that red shield icon? That means I broke the enemy's vitality there. So they lose a lot of that and allows me to deal more damage. The red sword icon indicates a debuff to their strength from breaking off the horn there. And, oh right, we got him. So for getting the dual horn stakes.
That's it.
What's what?
I've come up with a new recipe.
I could taste as
for. Hey, all right. Another recipe there. So you see, during that battle, I had.
Get out. Yeah.
Yeah, I had. What is it? A lot of tech bars left over there that I use to convert into AP that I can use for, well, learning more useful abilities. Let's get some more of these Luncheon tomatoes there. Let's see. So eventually what I want to do is get over to the west there to do, well, the lowest level hunt that we've got available there. Can we defeat the saber tusks? Find out next time on Let's Play Final Fantasy 15. This is HD Bailey, signing off. Have a good day!